and care. Friends, in the past few editions, we've heard and understood a bit about obesity, a bit about treatments for obesity, in what type of patients does obesity occur, and what a particular type of a patient, what type of a treatment is supposed to be done. Let us just revise through the whole thing. Friends, obesity means excess fat in the body. And whenever energy coming inside the body is more than energy spent, obesity results. Obesity, as it grows, it goes into morbid obesity. What is morbid obesity? Morbid obesity means that obesity has reached that level that because of obesity, various medical problems start coming into our body. So how do we treat it? For lower levels of obesity, there are very straightforward treatments. We can go for diet, we can go for exercise. But once our BMI, that is body mass index, goes beyond 30 with some medical problem, or goes beyond 32 even without any medical problem, the patient is far, far, far beyond the reach of getting treated or cured by diet alone. This is the time when we need to do something extra for the patient to ensure that the person loses weight in a healthy manner, and loses weight without any nutritional complications. So here comes the word bariatric surgery. What do we mean by bariatric surgery? Bariatric surgery means any surgery which can bring about a major weight loss. So when we plan to do any procedure which brings about a major weight loss, it is called as bariatric surgery. We also call it weight loss surgery, we call it as obesity surgery. There's so many names given to it. But finally, it means that we want to bring about a major weight loss in a patient who's excessively overweight. So friends, how did all this start? So I remember very fondly that it was in 1997 or 1998 when the first obesity surgery or bariatric surgery in the country was performed. This surgery that time was performed by open incision. That means we make a big long incision and the stomach or the abdomen is opened and we go inside and operate. But you can understand that if a patient is operated in an open manner, in an obese patient where there is so big or thick layers of fat, how difficult it would be. Improvisations have come, techniques have improved, and over a period of time we started doing the same procedure laparoscopically. Laparoscopy means keyhole surgery. Keyhole surgery means the same surgery is done with the help of multiple small holes through which our telescope goes inside the abdomen, and with that telescope we can observe the entire abdomen. We perform surgeries with the help of laparoscopic instruments or long thin instruments, and the effect of surgery is phenomenal. Effect of surgery is thus that patient is getting operated in the morning, by evening you find the patient walking around, by next day the patient is already walking up and down the stairs. The recovery is so fast that you will never see any patient having any problem. So this is, friend, called as laparoscopic weight loss surgery or bariatric surgery, where we have a few concepts on which we work on. We have a concept that we want early mobility, we want less pain, we want early return to work, and we want the patient to lead an extraordinary good quality of life. So friends, this bariatric surgery earlier, which was done in an open method, then came laparoscopy, which is now the most prominent method. Now recently, one more method has come of laparoscopic weight loss surgery, that is called as SILS. S-I-L-S. That is called as single incision laparoscopic surgery. In certain patients, we, because of cosmetic reasons, might take an incision just at the umbilicus, a small hole at the umbilicus, and the entire surgery is performed by SILS method. So this is also only a mode of entry into the abdomen, where the surgery which is done is called as bariatric surgery. The most common types of bariatric surgeries which are done are sleeve gastrectomy, which is called, in other words, even a stapling surgery, mini gastric bypass, gastric bypass, and various other surgeries. But primarily, if you try to divide them, they are of two types. One is restrictive surgery, where we decrease the amount of food coming into the body. Second is malabsorptive surgeries, where we allow indigestion or maldigestion to occur. That means if you take a particular amount of food inside the body, if you ingest it, everything will not get absorbed. Most of it or some part of it will be thrown away in the form of feces in stools. When a restrictive surgery is added with a malabsorptive surgery, it is called as a hybrid procedure. An example of that could be either a mini gastric bypass or a gastric bypass. Friends, details of these surgeries you will definitely come to know. We will be explaining that in a further knowledge capsules. But most important is every patient a candidate for bariatric surgery? No, friends. We do not operate every patient who would come to us for bariatric surgery. We have got certain indications, certain criteria, and the criteria which we follow in country, in Asia, are: 1. The patient should be at least a BMI of 30 with some medical problems, even if he doesn't have any medical problems. 2. The most important thing is that the patient should have had attempts at weight loss. So if a patient comes and tells us, "No, I will not do anything, you have to take care of me," we will say no, because we know that the commitment on part of the patient is going to be much, much, much lesser. So yes, patient should have attempted weight loss in the past. One more important thing is, patient should not be having any untreatable psychological problem, and the patient should not have any untreatable endocrine or hormonal problem. Once the patient satisfies these criteria, he or she may become an ideal candidate for bariatric surgery. And what do I tell you, friends? Before surgery, we have found obesity patients having multiple problems. Someone might be having diabetes, blood pressure, heart problems, cholesterol problems, infertility, and various other medical problems. How many does bariatric surgery take care of obesity? That is, it causes good weight loss over a period of time, weight loss without complications, weight loss without side effects, weight loss without nutritional deficiencies. But along with it, almost 70 to 80 to even 90% of the medical problems are resolved from the body. So friends, this is bariatric surgery. If you have liked this video or if you have found this worthwhile, please share it with your friends, relatives, or those people whom you find are leading a poor quality of life because of being overweight or because of being obese or morbidly obese. Help us in our campaign called as Give a Life, where you, by referring a patient for bariatric surgery, are literally gifting a life to your friend or relative. Bariatric surgery shows a new ray of life and shows your new beginning to your new life. Thank you.